This is about customer experience and the use of AI. But how have you been folding generative AI into that offering?
So, you know, if you think about our space, we cater to thousands of organizations around the world that are serving consumers. And we operate in the space of customer service. And we are that platform of organization when it comes to provide service to customers. When, you know, what AI brings to the customer service era, if you would like, or the customer service domain, is a true game changer. Because this industry has been struggling with three very important things. First is, you know, the lack of skilled labor, the ability to take decision in a very fast velocity, and mass personalization at scale.
Yes.
And that's exactly what AI can do to this industry. However, there is nothing generic, if you would like, about what those organizations need when it comes to AI, and this is exactly where we are and our company come into the picture.
You're seeing growth, of course, posting, what, 25% in the cloud revenue part of the business growth. But are you worried about some of the competitors that are coming on the space? If everyone suddenly starts being an AI specialist, if everyone can suddenly start changing up a business. I mean, I think this week alone, we've had IBM Watsonx, we've had Slack, well, Slack's owner, Salesforce, talking about how they're having the GPT within some parts of their business. Everyone's now offering this to their customers.
I would say on the contrary. First of all, we reported our earnings yesterday, and as you said, we had outstanding earnings with 25% growth in the cloud, driven by both cloud and AI. But when it comes to AI, although, you know, we all experienced so far, almost all of us experienced the beauty of generative AI, when it comes to deploying it in customer service for organization, there is nothing generic about it. Actually, we see with our customers, they are divided into two camps. Those that says, I will never put it in my customer service environment because it's not secured and I cannot control it. And the other that see the value but are concerned about taking something that generic and try it and doesn't work. Because what you need, you actually need to treat that AI as one of your employee. And as a brand, you want the AI to serve your brand, your reputation, and meet your business goal. So it needs to be trained with a lot of information.
Yes.
Information of tens of billions of past interactions with customers. And it's a proprietary information that you don't want to provide to the generative AI.
Yeah.
And that's why they come to us, to our platform. We have that data that is extremely, almost impossible to replicate given our history and the breadth of our offering. It's also about having it in a very secured environment.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to need the domain expertise. So it actually raises, I would say, the barrier of entry when it comes to technology in the space of customer service.
Gosh, Ed, it takes me back to the conversation we had a couple of months ago with Cathy Wood, talking about it all being about the power of your proprietary data. But also,
yeah.
I mean, that isn't to say, though, that still everyone's coining a term or using and referencing AI, no matter what part of the industry or what kind of company you are right now.
You make a really interesting point, both on proprietary data and referencing the term. Barak, I have free time on my hands, so I went through every single one of your earnings transcripts for the last year. 74 mentions of AI in the earnings call 24 hours ago. In the same quarter a year ago, 16 mentions of AI. In the quarter previous, going back to the fourth quarter, 58. How much pressure are you under to talk a big game around AI?
I don't think it's a matter of pressure. I think that we actually see it in our business. This is the type of discussions we have with our customers today. You know, our business up until several years ago was concentrated more on what we call the contact center. But all of a sudden,
yes,
with AI, we actually covered the entire journey of the customer. And we spent the last several years deploying and building AI capabilities that are injected and infused in our platform. And it is today one of the two things that are driving our business. A is the shift to the cloud that is still in the early innings in the customer service part. And even earlier than that is the AI. So actually we see it as the greatest opportunity we had for NICE, for our company, since I remember, and I've been with the company for 25 years.
Barak, you did beat on the top and bottom line. I just give us some guidance going forward the rest of this year. What does your customer base look like? Is there confidence to spend right now?
So we had a beat both on top line and bottom line, as you've mentioned, and we raised the guidance for the rest of the year. You know, we operate in a space that even in this economy, enterprises understand they still need to differentiate and protect their brand, elevate their brand, and of course provide an outstanding experiences to their customers. So we are a mission critical solution for them, and they actually continue to invest and invest even significantly. And that's why we raised the guidance for the year.